This is your Fox 10 News Now update.
Hi, everyone. I'm Sarah Wall with your Fox 10 News Now update. As we've been looking at the results of Alabama's primary runoff races, they're all in. So we're going to start with one of the most closely watched races, the one for the Republican nomination for U.S. Senate. With 100% of the precincts reporting, former Auburn football coach Tommy Tuberville beating former Attorney General Jeff Sessions. Tuberville receiving 61% of the vote, while Sessions received 39%. Now let's take a look at the results of the Republican runoff for Alabama's District 1 congressional race. With 100% of the precincts reporting, Mobile County Commissioner Jerry Carl receiving 52% of the vote, while former State Senator Bill Hightower got 48%. On the Democratic side, Marine veteran and businessman James Averhart coming out on top with 57% of the vote, research scientist Keani Gardner getting 43% of the vote. We continue to keep track of the coronavirus outbreak with COVID-19 cases rising in at least 39 states. Federal, state, and local leaders are considering more actions to slow the spread of the virus. The U.S. reporting its single day increase, highest increase in COVID-19 cases, with more than 67,000 in just the past 24 hours. That figure coming from Johns Hopkins University and New York Governor Andrew Cuomo adding Minnesota, Wisconsin and Ohio to his quarantine list of 22 states, which also includes Alabama. The Alabama Department of Public Health says Mobile County and the state of Alabama set new daily records for COVID-related deaths. Mobile County had 7, while the state reported 40 new deaths yesterday. As for cases of COVID-19, the Mobile County Health Department reports 105 new cases. Dr. Randy Murphy talking about some trends they are seeing.
Our daily moving average is jumping way up. So on average now, we're seeing about 100 or more cases added on average each day. This is twice as much as it was just 14 to 21 days ago. So again, a rapid increase. And the number of testing has stayed about the same over the last couple of weeks, but the percent positive of tests has continued to stay high. Last week, it was 19%.
The Mobile County Health Department is not posting the number of hospitalizations and deaths right now. It says it's working on a better way of determining those numbers. The South Alabama football team is hitting the pause button on its summer workouts. They will be administering another round of COVID-19 testing. The Jags conducted voluntary workouts up through the weekend, but with mandatory workouts allowed this week under the NCAA guidelines for the first time since the pandemic began, the school has elected to take a break to conduct further testing of student athletes and staff. That's according to South Alabama Athletic Director Dr. Joel Erdman. And so far, the Sun Belt Conference has yet to make a comment on the future of this year's football season. South Alabama is scheduled to play at Southern Miss to open the season.
I'm meteorologist Michael White with your Fox 10 Storm Tracker report. Early this morning, we do have a few showers located south of Fort Walton Beach and south of the Florida Panhandle. For now, it looks like things are going to stay relatively quiet during the morning hours across the Gulf Coast. But just like we've seen the last several days, additional rounds of showers and storms will fire off, and they'll do so with the daytime heating process. As the temperatures go up with the mugginess of the air, you'll end up dealing with heavy rain and lightning forming in random spots. But the coverage of rain today will be higher than it was yesterday. We'll see about 60 to 70% coverage of midday to afternoon rain and storms, and lightning will be the main threat. So when you hear that thunder roar, go indoors. Weather headlines for your Wednesday. We stay muggy. Afternoon storms are likely. What about the weather over the course of the weekend? Well, generally it's going to stay the same. We run the future cast, so you can see today as we see those temperatures go up, showers and storms begin to increase in number. Remember, the rate radar may not look exactly like what you see represented here, but it gives you a good idea on the coverage. Once we get to the evening hours, that'll be the last big push for heavy rain and lightning. Once the sun goes down, you'll see the showers weakening and starting to fade away. Here's how the next 7 days are going to stack up. Highs today will be in the lower 90s, and the reason why is because of an increased threat for afternoon showers and storms. Over the weekend, We see the rain coverage at 40 to 50%, so just standard July weather with muggy mornings, hot afternoons, and the risk of showers and storms. We'll be updating you throughout the day on your forecast right here on Fox 10 News Now.
Stay tuned to Fox 10 News throughout the day for the latest updates. This has been your Fox 10 News Now update.